My dear friends, praise the Lord. This is Father Francis Pinto. Today I come before you to share the word of God through the medium of Band for Jesus Worship Ministry. And the topic is, what is the driving force within me? Rather, what is that driving me? By the very word drive, we understand these days about pen drive that we use, about C drive, the computer language, local drive, F drive, etc. I am not talking about those drives. Rather, I am talking about inner strength or inner force which drives me to do some work or prompts me for some action. Everybody is driven by an inner force. That inner force can be positive at times, and the inner force can be negative at times. That depends on the person, what he is driven by. For example, Mother Teresa was always driven by the positive inner force, which we can call Holy Spirit. Therefore, all her actions, all that she said, all the service she did to the humanity, everything brought blessings to the people, and through all those things she glorified God. On the other hand, we can see the terrorist, the life of the terrorist. They are driven by an evil force or a negative energy from within, which prompts them to do something evil to the humanity and thus bring about destruction and harm. To explain this concept, I would like to narrate before you a small story. The story goes like this. There was a balloon seller who used to sell balloons near a school. Every day he used to gather up there because lots of children used to come to him and buy those balloons, and some of them were just looking at him, and he would release some balloons in the air, some red, some white, some yellow, some blue, and so on. And children enjoyed looking at those balloons flying in the air. There was a little boy who could not afford to buy those balloons, but he used to enjoy the balloons flying in the air. One day he comes to that balloon seller and asks, "Uncle, can a black balloon also fly in the air? Just like the other balloons, red, white, yellow, blue, and so on, can the black balloon also fly in the air?" And the balloon seller answers to that boy, "Son, it is not the color that makes the balloon fly in the air. It is what is filled inside the balloon. And what is filled inside the balloon is the gas. It is what is within that makes the balloon fly in the air." With this small example, we are called to reflect on our own life. What is that inner force driving me? Whether it is a negative force or it is a positive force. In the Gospel of Luke, chapter 4, verse 14, we see Jesus was filled with the Holy Spirit. And as he came back to Galilee to preach the good news, all that he preached, all that he did, and all the miracles that he performed, everything was so marvelous, so wonderful, so good. People enjoyed being in the company of Jesus. They looked at Jesus in every need, and they received blessings. They received healing because Jesus was driven by the Holy Spirit, and all the actions that flowed from Jesus, all the words that flowed from Jesus brought life to the people. We see the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians chapter 5, where St. Paul says, be filled with the Holy Spirit. Do not be filled with the worldly things, worldly materials, worldly riches, worldly powers, but be filled with the Holy Spirit, St. Paul says. Because if I am filled by the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of the Lord will lead me. And all that actions that I'm going to do, all that I'm going to say, will be directed by the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit will not allow me to do something negative or something wrong to anyone. Holy Spirit will always help me to do something good, something better, something beneficial to the world, to the humanity, and thus help me to praise God, to glorify God. Today, in today's modern world, we look for the color, just like that little boy thought that it's the color of the balloon that makes the balloon fly in the air. We look at the color of my mobile, color of my car, color of my house, color of my dresses. We go for all the externals. There are various workouts to make myself handsome, to make myself beautiful, and we go for that, spending lots of money so that I will be appreciated by people, I will be liked by people, and I will be admired by people. And for that we spend lot of money, lot of time, and lot of energy. None of these things can drive us, my dear brothers and sisters. The beauty that you admire, that will fade away one day. The beautiful teeth or the beautiful hair that you have, as you grow old, they may fall down. The beautiful cheeks, the beautiful skin, that may grow old and it may be filled with wrinkles one day. The power that you have got, whether it's muscle power, whether it's money power, will not be helpful in time of need. All your intelligence can fail, as we see in today's world. Because of the coronavirus, the whole world is in turmoil. People are not able to find out some medicines. All the money power, all the intellectual power has failed. People are not able to find out any solution to this problem. So we cannot rely on our power of mind, of money, of muscle. All this can fail us at any time. So we need to depend on the power which comes from within. And that power should be of the Holy Spirit. If I am driven by the power of the Holy Spirit, all that flows from me can bring lots of blessings to people. That can bring lots of blessings to people. So let us not go for the worldly powers, worldly things to drive me out. Everything will come to an end. Today I should be driven by the power of the Holy Spirit. Therefore, I have posed before you a question: what drives me out? So you need to ask yourself, what is that driving force within you? Whether it is negative or whether it is positive. If it is negative force driving you out, we better mend our ways. Suppose I criticize always to someone and make stories about someone. That means I am driven by that spirit of criticism. If I am expressing my anger every time, that means I am driven by the power of anger. If there is pride in me and I am boasting about myself, that means I am driven by the power of pride. If there is money and the worldly luxuries that I am speaking about, that means I am driven by the power of money and luxuries. All this will fail me. My dear brothers and sisters, the only thing that is lasting, and that is the Holy Spirit. Whether you are young, whether you are old, whether you are literate or illiterate, whether you are rich or poor, if you are filled by the Holy Spirit, all that you do will give glory to God. And for that very purpose, God has chosen us to give glory to His name through our responsibilities, through our works, through our activities. Therefore, all that I do, I think, and I say should be driven out by the power of the Holy Spirit. If the power of the Holy Spirit is leading me, then I can lead a life worthy of my call. God has given us a vocation, a mission, and I must fulfill that mission. I must live out that vocation. And to live out that vocation and to fulfill that mission, I need the power of the Holy Spirit to drive me out. And as long as I am driven by the power of the Holy Spirit, I can bring glory to God, I can serve humanity, and I can love people as Jesus has commanded me to love one another as He has loved me. So my dear brothers and sisters, through this small video clip, I would like to encourage you to reflect on the topic, what is driving me out? What is that driving force dwelling within me? Let us check. If the driving force is negative, I must replace with the positive one. I must replace with the Holy Spirit if that is evil spirit in me. So let us pray to God to anoint us with the power of the Holy Spirit and His gifts and the fruits of the Holy Spirit, that in everything that we may be able to praise God, glorify God, and bring about His blessings to people those with whom we live. And thus, let us glorify God. May the good Lord bless us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you, friends.